when I was going towards Kremlin for the second time, you know, to go and visit the place, I happened to walk over a bridge and I saw a picture which was quite similar to me. The picture was similar, but not the person, you know, the name of the person. So this is Boris and his Boris Nemtsov. Boris Nemtsov is like, I mean, he was the opposition, very strong opposition candidate who was against Putin, and he was assassinated in the year 2015, right in this place. So they have kept a picture of him, and you can see garlands have been arranged in his remembrance. So yeah, it was kind of shocking to me to know that he was assassinated right in front of Kremlin, and yeah, that must be some sort of a political vendetta. But yes, people do care for him, and I hope, you know, or I believe that the good cause that he started continues.
Not sure if the, you know, the cathedral bell is audible, but yes, now I think you'll be able to hear it.
You can see the St. Basil Cathedral right in front of us, and there is also a holding of, you know, iPhone 13. There will be many more iPhone 13s coming up, but there will be only one St. Basil Cathedral, which is so magnificent looking in front of us.
Never been to art museums, but this one definitely I cannot miss it, for the reason it's the 13th most highly visited art museum, and I'm there already. So this is Tretyakov Art Museum, and yeah, there we'll be able to go and get the tickets. So what I read from Wikipedia is Tretyakov is an artist himself, and he has exhibited like 2000 arts in this museum. I mean, they have exhibited his art, and also he has collected art from around the world. We could see a lot of children have gathered here, maybe with their parents or probably with their teachers, to visit this one of the most visited museums in the world. I think it's 12th or 13th, number doesn't matter, but what's very special is it's a collection of all Russian art being exhibited here, and we see that, you know, this is the entrance, and we have to pay the ticket and maintain the distance. So welcome to the welcome to the COVID era again. This is a new normal, but it's fine until we are able to, you know, visit the art gallery, art museum, by the way. So they are open from 10 to 6. Vakhod and Kasi. Okay. Something is written here 10 to 9. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's weekday and weekend thing. Not sure, but let's buy the tickets.
ticket to the art gallery was 500 rubles. And when I went to the first floor, that's where, you know, the whole gallery display began. And in the beginning sessions, I saw mostly, you know, portraits of some very noble person from Russia, the so-called kings and queens of Russia. And then later on, the scene started changing. The later section of the museum had, you know, more display of how the life was in Russia. As you can see, you know, a troubled family with the father who is kind of not having much hope. Maybe he's in debt or something like that. To experience such a art, you should really visit this place. And you also see the person who created this sculpture. Another interesting picture was, you know, the painting of Taj Mahal. Next one is a picture of Ladakh region that was experienced by a Russian traveler in those times. It's actually the glacier on the roadside from Kashmir to Ladakh region. And then a portrayal of, you know, a young girl being wedded to an old man. So this was some sort of a cruelty, yes. And it's not only in Russia, but it was indeed a common sight across. Another gem of an artwork which showed, you know, a beggar begging, or, you know, I don't know, he's making some communication with a sadhu. So this sounded quite dramatic to me.